Okay, so this skills test for Module 7 involves building a simple circuit. Now, a simple circuit is just a electrical circuit that has essentially one source of energy. Usually, in this case, it's a battery pack. Could be just a single battery or a power, some sort of a power supply. In this case, it's just a battery pack. And then it only has one energy consumer, which in this case is a resistor. So when you load up the simulation, you hit begin, you'll see your simple circuit. It's a loop. And you'll notice there's a couple of meters here. Now, the meters aren't described in the introductory material, so I encourage you to go ahead and read through that and also read through the section about the battery pack. The first thing you're asked to do, well, actually, I'll just show you, first of all, how these meters are read. All you have to do is click on them. When you click on them, you will see in this case, this is an ammeter. It measures current. It measures the number of charges that are flowing through it every second, and it gets a reading. In this case, it's in milliamps. The voltmeter measures voltage, essentially the amount of energy dropped by each charge when it moves through a load. In this case, it's the resistor. So that's how a voltmeter works. And notice that they are wired differently. In the case of an ammeter, it's wired in what's called series. Charges have no choice. They must go through the ammeter in order to continue on through the circuit. If you disconnected the ammeter, no current would flow through the circuit. The voltmeter, notice it doesn't, it's not an integral part of the circuit. I could disconnect either one of these leads from the voltmeter, and charges would continue to go around this loop. It wouldn't matter. So a voltmeter is wired across a resistor or across a load because its job is not to count the number of charges that are moving through the circuit. Essentially, it conducts a little interview. It stops a charge on this side of the load. And it says, hey, charge, how much energy do you have? And it gets an answer. Charge moves along, and it gets interviewed again on the other side of the load saying, hey, how much energy you got? And then it compares those two answers, and that winds up on the display as being the voltage drop across that load. So notice that the voltmeter and the ammeter are wired differently because they perform different tasks.